Welcome back to News Plus, everyone. I'm Mark Seagraves, and now a look at education. You know that testing is critically important to students, but also to teachers. Here in the District of Columbia, teachers actually bonus on their students' test scores. Well, our correspondent, Robin Hamilton, had a chance to talk about some of the flaws in educational testing.
There is no question that the education system in the United States is in crisis, and it seems like almost everyone has an opinion on how to fix it. But there has been some growing concern that a lot of times we don't hear from the educators, the people who are on the ground dealing with it day to day. Today we're here joined by Rodney Jordan, who is an educator and author, and he is hosting an education summit to talk about this very issue. Hi, Rodney.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Thanks for joining us. I really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
So the summit is called Learners, Inc. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And I want to know, why did you feel it important to create the summit?
Well, there are a lot of issues in education impacting our students in grades K through 12 that need to be addressed. And a lot of times there are people talking about education that have never been educators, and mm-hmm. so people don't really get the truth. And so what I wanted to do was host an education summit so that people can find out exactly what's going on in our classrooms and what is going on in our schools. And so because of that, I decided to host an education summit.
Okay, you are an educator yourself. Tell me about your background and what you do.
So I'm a fifth and sixth grade STEM teacher. Mm-hmm. In the city of Manassas, Virginia. This will be my eighth year teaching.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. And so I've also written two books, mm-hmm. Tired of Being Black and From the Heart of a Teacher.
Okay.
I've also coached basketball. I started a club at my school called the Future Leaders of America Club. Mm-hmm. So just very active and involved in education.
Since you are in the trenches, what do you see? What is the deficiency, the troubles you see facing kids in the education system?
As I talk to other educators, I see that we have the same concerns. And one of our biggest concerns today is testing. Mm-hmm. Testing has taken over education so much so that teachers are becoming burnt out and frustrated because we spend about 50% of our year on standardized testing. And so mm-hmm. teachers are getting tired of it, saying that, you know, school just isn't fun anymore. The kids are burnt out, and the kids will even say, not another test. Are we testing again? We've done this so many times this year. So that's one of the biggest issues. Another issue is social promotion, where students are being passed on to the next grade even when they're not ready. Mm-hmm. So because of that, we have students in the ninth grade reading on a fifth grade level. Mm-hmm. And so they're leaving high school if they don't drop out first, and they're just not prepared for the real world.
What are your thoughts about how to stop this problem, not only from advancing kids who are not ready, but also to get around the issue of standardized testing? Some people say that that's just the way to go to really measure a child's ability. What is your approach to not only measuring their ability, but getting them through?
I believe in growth assessments. Mm-hmm. I think that it's important to see where a child is at the beginning of the year and measure how much they've grown over the course of the year. I think growth assessments are a better solution than standardized testing, because you can't tell teachers to differentiate their instruction, yeah. and then you standardize the test. It can't be one size. It can't be one test fits all. It mm-hmm. should be let's meet the needs of our students and get the data that we need. As far as the social promotion, I don't think that you should push kids on when they're not ready. Mm-hmm. If you're reading on a third grade level, you should be in the third grade. Mm-hmm. You should not be in the eighth grade reading on a third grade level. I think that is a disservice to our students, and I think ultimately it leads to bigger problems in our society.
Right.
Because when we send children out into the world unprepared, how can they function in the workplace?
Right.
Absences are a problem. So if students aren't on time to school, or if they aren't showing up to school, then why would they be on time for a job?
Right. Who can attend this summit? I mean, who do you think? I know that it's going to be a place of educators, but is it going to be the, you know, you're preaching to the choir? Are other people available or open to attending something like this?
So registration is free, mm-hmm. and it is open to the public. We would love to see parents there. We would love to see community leaders. We would love to see school board members. We would love to see city council members, we would love to see any and every one, preferably the lawmakers. They need to know what's actually going on. Instead of getting on TV to fulfill an agenda, it should be, oh, this is really happening in our schools. This is really what's happening to our kids. And so we want any and everyone to attend the summit. And what I always say is, if you think back to the Ray Rice situation, Ray Rice didn't miss football last year because Ray Rice hit his fiance. Ray Rice missed football because the public saw what he did. There was public outrage, and therefore the NFL had to react. If we do the same thing in education, we'll have a better system for our kids. If the public finds out what's going on in our schools, then the public, I'm pretty sure, will become outraged. And then letters will start going to senators into the House, and so we'll have a better system.
Thanks for that, Robin. Stay right there. When News Plus returns, we talk to one of the greatest vocalists of all time.